Hi, very good morning. Welcome to my next video lecture. Before I am introducing my topic, I wish to show my favorite the hero or my favorite character from the Hollywood movie. Identify the character, please. Can you say who is this? Yeah, it's none other than the great character, the Batman by Robert Pattinson. He's my favorite hero in Hollywood movies. I wish to buy a bat suit for me. Then I Google it, what about the rate, what about the cost of this bat suit. Then my eyes will strike on a particular image which will describe the rate or the cost of each parts of bat suit. Here it is. Then the fact is that it has high cost. It's a very expensive suit. And another interesting thing is that when I gone through the parts, I caught an interesting thing, an interesting fact. Did you ever see this body armor which is made up by this Kevlar? And this groin arms which is made up by the same Kevlar. The glove which is made up by Kevlar, knee pad. And elbow, most of the parts which was made up by the same material, Kevlar. Then I think, what's the use? Why they use this particular thing for the preparation of this much expensive or this bat suit? My dear students, that's today's topic. Yeah, I'm introducing today's topic, that is Kevlar. As a student, you have to learn some topics about Kevlar. What is the common name of Kevlar? And what are the monomers of Kevlar? Which type of, it's a type of polymer. Which is the monomers of this Kevlar? How it is synthesis? What are the applications? What are the properties? And so on, so on, so. Let us discuss each and everything in detail. First of all, you have to study that. It is a common name for the team or the polymer. Polyparaphenylene terephthalamine. Once more, Kevlar is a common name for polyparaphenylene terephthalamide. Second point is, which need to study the monomers. The first monomer, this is the structure of the first monomer. Let us go through the structure. There is a benzene ring and there is one NH2 groups and there is two NH2 group, one on the first position, second, third, fourth, and second NH2 group on the fourth positions. So we can call it as, this is 1, 4. This is phenylene group, diamine, because NH2 is also known as amines. So what is the first monomer? That is 1,4 phenylene diamine. And the second monomer is, well, let us go through the structure, the same. There is a benzene ring and there is 1 and 4th position is occupied by C double bond of CL groups. And this is known as terephthalyl chloride. So let us discuss, let us recall the monomers names, 1,4 phenylene diamine and terephthalyl chloride. Do you know there is any relation between these names and the common and the IUPAC name of Kevlar? Yes. Poly means the term which is used in front of every polymer. Polyethylene, polyamide, polyester, and polyvinyl chloride, polyacrylonitrite. So poly is the term which is used in front of a polymer. And this is, did you see that? Paraphenylene. This term is coming from the term 1,4 phenylene diamine. What do you mean by 1,4? And these two positions we can call it as, these are para positions. So paraphenylene terms is came from 1,4 phenylene here also. So the polyparaphenylene terephthalamide means terephthalyl chloride. From the term, this is the terephthalyl amide is came from. Actually, this monomer is an example for a condensation polymerization. What do you mean by condensation polymerization? Condensation polymerization is a type of polymerization in which the polymer during the polymerization, small molecules such as water, NH3, HCl are eliminated during polymerization. Here also, during the polymerization of this polyparaphenylene terephthalamide, some small molecules of HCl will be eliminated from 1,4-phenylene diamine and terephthalate chloride. That's why this polymer Kevlar is placed under condensation polymerization. We can see that according to the nature or the number of types of monomers, we can divide polymer into two: homopolymer and copolymer. Homopolymer is only one type, copolymer means more than one type. So we can see that Kevlar belongs to copolymer category. And the third point is, and this is an example for a conducting polymer. Normally, polymers are insulator in nature, but some polymer which can conduct electricity and heat, and they can call it as conducting polymer. So it's an example for that. The next thing is, let us discuss the synthesis of this Kevlar or 1-polyparaphenylene terephthalamide. So here the equation, what is this? This is 1,4-phenylene diamine. What about this? This is terephthalyl chloride. During the polymerization of this particular Kevlar, the molecule is eliminated HCl, and this H atom will be eliminated from this 1,4-phenylene diamine, and the Cl atom is eliminated from the molecule terephthalyl chloride. And another thing is that each monomer consisting of two groups, the 1,4-phenylene diamine consisting of two NH2 groups, and terephthalyl chloride consisting of two chloride groups. During the formation of this particular polymer, one monomer, or you can see that there is n number of each monomers are be polymerizing, then it will release 2 HCl. So we can say that if n molecules are condensing, then we can say that there are n molecules of HCl are be eliminated. Then that's the structure. So we can see that during the polymerization, this -2NHCl, which is n number of HCl, is eliminated from this. Let us discuss the structure. This is the structure of Kevlar or this polyparaphenylene terephthalamide. Did you see that? You can see an interesting thing. You can see there are a number of hydrogen bonds between hydrogen and nitrogen, and so and so. Then due to this type of hydrogen bond is an example for intramolecular hydrogen bond. Between the molecule, we can see this hydrogen bonding. Due to the existence of this intramolecular hydrogen bonding, we can say that this is highly stronger. That's the main reason which we use this particular thing for this for the preparation of body armors. Let us discuss the applications. The first property is that it is 5 times stronger than steel. This is very stronger than five times stronger than steel, which means steel can withstand most of the impact. So high impact resistance. So that's the main reason which we used, or the in the Hollywood movies they use this Kevlar for the preparation of this the body armor parts. The second thing is that it is lightweight material. That's why this Kevlar is not only used in these Bollywood movies by the action heroes. The same material which is used by the soldiers for making this body armor. The second main reason is that it is very stronger. The second reason is that it is very light material. Third point is that it will chemical resistance. We know that in these movies, in this movie Batman's the movie, you can see that this Batman need to face a lot of consequences, a lot of attacks by the bad mans or the whatever to say that villain man, you know, there are a lot of attacks will be faced. Maybe they are from chemical attacks or them from fire attacks. So idin okke resist cheyan pattunna oru property aayirikkanam avarude body armor. That's why they are using the main using the reason nu parayunnathu moonanaanu. One, the first one is that it is highly stronger, it is a light material, it is highly chemical resistance and it do not corrode. And the second one is that it is highly structural rigidity. The second thing is that flame resistant and self extinguishable. നമ്മുടെ നാട്ടിൽ എന്നൊക്കെ പറയുന്നത് ഈ പറയുന്ന നമ്മുടെ ഫയർ എക്സ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷേഴ്സ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന സമയത്ത് ഫയർഫോഴ്സുകാർ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് ഒരു കോട്ടാണ്, ഒരു ജാക്കറ്റാണ്. ബട്ട് ഇൻ അമേരിക്കൻ മൂവീസ് എന്നൊക്കെ പറയുമ്പോൾ ഈ ബോളിവുഡ് ഹോളിവുഡ് മൂവീസ് ശരിക്കും നമ്മൾ നോക്കിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ മനസ്സിലാവും, അവിടുത്തെ പോലീസുകാരാണെങ്കിലും അതുപോലെ എന്തെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ തീ ഉണ്ടാവുകയാണെങ്കിൽ, നമ്മൾ BBC ന്യൂസിലൊക്കെ കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്, ഏതെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ തീയൊക്കെ പിടിച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അവരൊരു കുറേ കറുത്ത ടീംസാണ് വരുന്നത്, കുറച്ച് ജാക്കറ്റ് ഇട്ട ടീംസ്. അവരുടെ ജാക്കറ്റിൻ്റെ മുകളിൽ അവർ വേറൊരു ജാക്കറ്റ് ഇട്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് സേഫ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഓൾസോ മെയ്ഡ് അപ്പ് ബൈ ദ സെയിം മെറ്റീരിയൽ കെവില. ദ റീസൺ ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫ്ലെയിം റെസിസ്റ്റൻ്റ് ആൻഡ് സെൽഫ് എക്സ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷബിൾ. ആൻഡ് നമുക്കറിയാൻ പറ്റും ഈ പറയുന്ന ബാറ്റ്മാനും എന്തോരും തീയുടെ അറ്റാക്കൊക്കെ വരുന്നത്, എന്നിട്ടും ആ പറഞ്ഞ സാധനത്തിൽ ബാറ്റ്മാന് ഒന്നും പറ്റുന്നില്ല, തെറിച്ചു വീഴുന്നതെന്ന് മാത്രം. അത് ദാറ്റ്സ് ഡിപെൻഡ്സ്, അത് മൂവിയിൽ കാണിക്കുന്നതാണ്. പക്ഷെ അതിൻ്റെ പിന്നിലുള്ള കെമിസ്ട്രി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫ്ലെയിം റെസിസ്റ്റൻ്റ് ആണ്, സെൽഫ് എക്സ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷബിൾ ആണ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി ടെൻസൈൽ സ്ട്രെങ്ത് ആൻഡ് വിച്ച് ഈസ് ഹൈ 5 times സ്ട്രോങ് ദാൻ സ്റ്റീം. And then let us discuss the applications. The first application, it is used for making military helmets, bulletproof vest, or reinforced for military vehicles, for making lightweight military equipments. Military ennu parna team padichu kanyal, let us by heart all things, which are the military equipments. It is helmet is a military equipment, bulletproof vest is a military equipment, military vehicles and lightweight military equipments. And it is also used for making strong ropes and cables. It is also used by this military soldiers. And it is also used for the preparation of personal protective products such as riding shoes, otherwise industrial gloves, fighting apparel, body armor, body parts, etc. So thank you. That's about this particular video about Kevlar. Let us recall once again what is a Kevlar. Is a common name for polyparaphenylene terephthalamide. It's a copolymer, so we can see that the monomers are 1,4-phenylene thiamine and terephthaloyl chloride. It's a copolymer, it is a condensation polymer. During this preparation of this particular Kevlar, it eliminates 2N molecules of N molecules are undergoing polymerization, then 2N molecules of HCl are be eliminated from that. The next thing is the structure. We can see the structure, it's an intramolecular hydrogen bonding assist, so we can see that is high times for stronger than steel. It is fire extinguishable, self extinguishable, fire protective ana, otherwise it is highly chemical resistant, it is highly temperature rigid, it is lightweight and tensile strength under. Due to that, we are using this particular Kevlar material for the preparation of military equipment such as helmets, the body parts, the military equipment such as the helmets, these body body parts, body bulletproof vest, and low cost the low weight military equipments and military vehicles parts. And it is also used for the preparation of cables and ropes, and it is also used for preparation of protecting materials such as riding shoes, etc. Thank you. Have a nice day.